Hello. Welcome to the first stage of the strategic planning process. If you're watching this video, that means that you signed up for the Vision and Goals group. That's the group that's going to have the responsibility for creating a vision statement of what the University of Evansville will look like in the next 5 years, and then creating between 5 and 8 strategic priorities or strategic goals designed to get us from where we are now to where we want to be in 5 years. This is going to be a big job, and it's a job that we're going to have a lot of help doing. I've been amazed at how many people have signed up to participate in strategic planning at this first phase. We've got more than 100 people who have signed up to be in one of these first two groups, about 60 in group two, your group, about 40 in the other group. And that's really impressive, and it's important, and all of that input is going to make the plan much stronger. It also means that we're going to have to supplement our face-to-face meetings with some smart collaboration technology. So what I want to do right now in this video is introduce you to the SharePoint site that we're going to use to collaborate, and then talk a little bit about what's going to happen throughout the year, how the strategic planning process is going to unfold, and then we'll talk specifically about the charge of the Vision and Strategic Goals group. I'm fairly new to SharePoint, but I really like what I've seen so far. We are now using this as the primary tool for collaboration for the VP Ops group, and we're starting to use it for the Dean's Council. It's a lot like Blackboard, except it's designed more for people who are collaborating and less for somebody who's instructing. So there are a lot of tools that we have here that allow us to talk to each other, share documents, jointly edit documents. We're going to have a document library, first of all, on this site that will contain pretty much all of the previous work that's been done in strategic planning. As I said a few times already, the strategic planning process is not starting from square one. We have done, in all of the academic areas and in all of the other areas, we've done an enormous amount of work on strategic planning over the next 5 years. We have more strategic plans and more objectives and more values and more goals than we can incorporate. So this is going to be a process of taking what's been done and whittling it down and figuring out who we are, figuring out who we aren't, figuring out what the things that we've said we want to do, which ones are the most important, which ones are the ones that are going to define us in the future. So we're going to have all of these documents loaded onto the site. We're also going to have a bulletin board for collaboration. There's an email area that maps on to your Outlook that will allow you to keep all of the conversations from the group in one place, sort of curated and attached to the discussions that occur in this group. And then as we get drafts and as we get early ideas, we're going to put them on the site and let everybody comment on them and have sort of a joint editing process. That it's not going to take the place of the groups that you're going to be meeting face-to-face in, but it is going to supplement those groups, make sure that people who can't attend the meetings, because when you've got 60 people who have to come to a group, there are always going to be people who can't attend certain meetings, and it's going to allow for more people to contribute than can in a 1 or even a 2 hour meeting, just because of the time limitations of the meetings that we're going to have. So log into this site often, please. Bookmark it. Things are going to start moving quickly, and this site is going to allow communications between group members, the group chairs, and me. I will be putting new things on this site almost every day during the strategic planning process. And what I want and what I think we need as an institution is for everybody who is involved in this to have a maximum opportunity to share your feelings, to share your input, and to help to support the plan and the ideas that are emerging, so that these plans have input from as far across the university as we can possibly take them. So thank you very much for your time. Thank you for being willing to devote a good portion of your semester to this work. And what I want to do now is talk a little bit about the whole process, what the strategic plan is designed to accomplish, what the elements are going to be, and what it's going to look like when it's all done.
Before we start talking about what the strategic plan is, I want to talk a little bit about what I hope it isn't going to end up being like, and that is everybody else's strategic plan. Linda White, the chair of our board, shared this cartoon with the whole board at a meeting last year, and it stuck with me for a long time. It's funny because it's true. I've read dozens of strategic plans from colleges and universities, and just about all of them would fit into this cookie-cutter model. Grow the endowment, attract high-ability students, support faculty and staff excellence, build a diverse global community. These are good things to do. They're what everybody is saying that they're going to do. So these aren't things that distinguish us. So the first thing I'm going to ask everybody to do when we start talking about mission and vision and objectives and goals is move beyond what almost everybody else is doing, because the purpose of this strategic plan has got to be to find ways to distinguish ourselves and to talk about things that we can do if other universities can't do. Because we've got to start articulating the reasons that students should come to the University of Evansville and not one of the other 3,000 colleges and universities that have this same strategic plan. So, what is a strategic plan? First of all, it's as much of a process as it is a product, and maybe even more of a process than it is a product. And that means that we're going to produce a document. My guess is it'll be ultimately about a 30-page document, and it's going to contain a lot of important things that we talk about, but it's not going to contain everything that we talk about. And the fact that we're getting together in groups that cut across the various areas of our campus and talking about who we are, talking about what makes us unique, these things are valuable independent of the product that we end up producing, because these are conversations that every healthy institution and every healthy university has to have from time to time. We need to have serious conversations about what is most important to us, because if we don't understand that, we're going to have a very difficult time articulating it and explaining it to other people. A strategic plan starts out by defining the core mission of our organization. What is the University of Evansville? What makes us different than other universities, other organizations? What are the values that are most important to us? We start with these. Now, the strategic plan moves beyond these things, but until we have a very solid sense of what defines us, what makes us matter, then it is not going to be possible to build the kinds of goals and objectives that we need to create in order to move forward. We are creating a vision for the near to mid-range future. The operative timeline of the plan will be 2019 through 2024. So it's a 5-year strategic plan, 10 semesters, 5 summers, and we're going to specify some specific things that we're going to do in order to get to a specific place. And those things are going to then start being tied to our budgeting, start being tied to our planning, being tied to how we represent ourselves to accreditors, donors, students, community members, potential hires, potential faculty and staff members. All of these things answer the question, where are we going? The strategic plan establishes goals that allow us to enact our vision and enact what we see as our most important functions while remaining faithful to those core identities. So the strategic plan is supposed to prevent mission creep. It's supposed to prevent us from trying to do everything and trying to do more good things than we have the resources to do. So I like to say that strategic planning is not just about what we are going to do, it's about what we're not going to do. We have to decide what's most important so we don't waste or dilute resources on things that are less important. And if we don't do that, we end up trying to do all good things simply because they're good. And neither we nor any other university has the resources to do all good things. We also have to devise concrete ways to answer the question, are we winning? Are we succeeding? Are we doing what we say we're going to do? So after we design the goals and objectives, we're going to have to create action steps and measurement metrics so that we can hold ourselves accountable to ourselves, to our board of trustees, to our community, for making the goals that we plan a reality. When this is all over in May, when we have a strategic plan completed, we're going to have what I anticipate will be about a 30-page document, and it's going to have 9 different kinds of things in it, the 9 elements of the strategic plan. And I want to go over each one of these in this very brief presentation. We're going to have a mission statement, a set of core values, a vision statement, strategic goals, objectives, action steps, key performance indicators, a budget, and a timeline. So here's how, here's what all of these mean, and here's how they're all going to come together. I just want everyone to have a sense of how what we're doing right now is going to fit into something larger, and how it's going to fit into a finished product. Mission statement should be a simple, direct, easily memorizable one sentence, if there's any way we can make it one sentence, but something short that when people read it, when people see it, anybody who knows anything about the University of Evansville says, yeah, that's it. That gets us. And they're deceptively simple. A good mission statement can be very short, but can, in those few words, boil down the essence of an institution. Here are some examples of mission statements that I think are really good. First one, from the TED organization, you know, the TED Talks, they have a 2-word mission statement, spreading ideas. The Humane Society, they have a 4-word mission statement, celebrating animals, confronting cruelty. And I'd be willing to bet that just about anybody who read that could guess that it was the Humane Society or some very similar organization just from those 4 words. It's that good of a mission statement. The Smithsonian, the increase and diffusion of knowledge. The Monterey Bay Aquarium, to inspire conservation of the oceans. Oxfam, to create lasting solutions to poverty, hunger, and social injustice. The March of Dimes, we help moms have full-term pregnancies and research the problems that threaten the health of babies. And Habitat for Humanity International, seeking to put God's love into action, Habitat for Humanity brings people together to build homes, communities, and hope. So there's a couple of mission statements that tell you, I think, what's essential about a nonprofit institution, what they do better than anybody else, what motivates the people that work there, what makes people excited to get up in the morning and go to work, because these institutions assure the world and assure their own employees and volunteers that this is what they're about. This is what they do. Once we've affirmed and articulated a mission statement, our next task is going to be to create or to affirm a set of core values. And the core values are ideas, ideals that are so important to us as an institution that we can't even imagine not having them. That if all of a sudden we could no longer express these values, we would pack up and say there's no point anymore of even being us. We're all going to get into another line of work. And these are things that are completely non-negotiable to us. And there are things that everybody at UE should know and be able to discuss. So there can't be too many of them. There's no set number. Most institutions that I think do this well articulate 3 or 4 values that they say are core to who they are. They're constitutive of their purpose as an institution. So we articulate the mission and the core values, and then we go on to articulate a vision. The vision is going to be a 1-paragraph to 1-page statement of where the organization sees itself in the next 5 to 10 years. So in 2024, what does the University of Evansville look like? These are normally written in the present tense, as if we were writing it in the future. We will say, in 2024, the University of Evansville is, and then we express a vision that is clearly tied to the mission, that articulates the core goals, and that that articulates the kind of institution that we see ourselves realistically becoming. So this can't be entirely idealistic. It's aspirational. These are the things that we aspire to being, but we're going to try to create a plan to take us from here to there. And that means that this is going to have to be an achievable vision, something that if we are willing to put in the work, the resources, and the institutional attention to this vision, we have a reasonable opportunity to accomplish what we say we're going to accomplish. In order to get to the vision statement, we create a set of strategic goals. The strategic goals are the what gets us from here to there. They look at where we are right now, what we need to focus on, what we need in order to move towards and become the institution that we describe in the vision statement. These aren't things that are absolutely crucial to the inherent mission and values of the institution, though they're based on those things. But the strategic goals are the things that we think it's most important to focus on now. Things that will take us from where we are and where we think we need to go. This is an opportunity to establish what we're not going to focus on right now. Because we can only support institutionally a limited number of initiatives, we have to say, these are our goals, this is where we're going to put our resources and our attention, and there are lots of other wonderful, powerful, meaningful, good things that we could do, that we may do at a future time, but for the next 5 years, these are the things that are going to get our attention, because we're moving to a place, we're moving towards a vision. And to do that, we can't dilute our focus too much. So then we're going to have a series of objectives and action steps. And before I talk about these, I just want to talk a little bit about the difference. Because in my experience, one of the great skills that we all need to cultivate is understanding the level of abstraction of a goal, an objective, and an action step. So just a concrete set of examples here. A goal is a large area of focus that we want to make progress towards during the planning period. UE will become a more important part of local communities in southern Indiana. That's not quite either we did it or we didn't, because it's scalable. It's something that we believe is important, if we believe that this is important. It's something that we can make progress towards. It's something we can always do better, though. So it's something that we measure our progress towards, but we don't say, okay, now that goal is done, we move on to something else. An objective is a more specific, measurable target that we are saying we will achieve this during the planning period. At the end of 5 years, we will create curricular connections to students in local high schools. That's an objective. That is something that we are not doing now, we're not doing much of now, that we can do more of. So the objective is something that we complete during the time period. And an action step is a very specific task that's going to be completed at a very specific time. So we would say in the fall of 2020, we will meet with 5 high schools to discuss dual enrollment programs at UE. And that's something we can put on a timeline, and that's something that we can say, this is what we're going to do, and if we don't do it, then we have to explain to ourselves and our board why we aren't doing it. Objectives, which are going to be probably the key part of the second phase of the plan, objectives should be what the people who say such things say are SMART. And that is an acronym, and it means specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and timed, or things that we can actually put a timeline to. Now, it's very possible that achievable and realistic mean the same things, but then we would just have SMAT. So we're going to go with the objectives are going to be SMART objectives, and we're going to put them in a chart that looks something like this. And this and the next slide are taken from the last strategic plan that I directed, which was at Newman University, my previous institution. We have a set of goals. Here is goal one. The university will nurture a positive, uplifting environment by supporting its human, financial, and physical resources. And we have a set of objectives under this goal. And I believe there were three or four objectives under this goal, but I'm just going to show you one here. We will develop and maintain physical resources and technological infrastructures that will allow us to meet our curricular and co-curricular goals. And then action steps, build a health science center, get a course management system up and running, develop standards for bring your own device protocol, implement a process for maintaining a 5-year rolling capital improvement plan. Those are action steps where we say we're going to do them at a certain time, and we're going to, this is how much it's going to cost, and these then become our budget. When we create our budget for that year, we will put this all on a timeline like this. Here is spring 2011. It's already happened. These are the goals, the objectives, and the action statements. And we say that the action item is, this is the person who is responsible. And every semester, every year, this becomes our budget, and this becomes the first thing that we talk about at our Dean's Council or our VP Ops Group or our President's Council. These are the things that we pull up and we say, this is what we're going to do. And that's what the whole strategic plan is going to look like when it's done. And I hope you have a good idea or a good sense of what we're trying to accomplish. Now I want to move on to talking very specifically about the vision statement and the strategic goals that your group has been tasked with creating and what your part in this plan is going to be for the next 10 weeks. So what are we talking about when we're talking about a vision statement? In the model that we're using, vision statements can be from one sentence to two or a maximum of three paragraphs. It has to be something we can fit on a single page at least. And it's something that's written in the present tense as if it were 5 years in the future, as if the strategic plan had already been completed and everything that we set out to do, we accomplished. So the vision statement is simply a description of what the University of Evansville will look like if the strategic plan is successful. What kinds of attributes will we have? What kinds of characteristics? What kind of reputation? If we do our jobs exactly the way that they're supposed to do them, what is the destination going to look like? So the vision statement is the destination for which the strategic plan is the road. The vision statement has to be aspirational, but it can't be unreachable. It would be wonderful if we had a vision like we will be a university with a $10 billion endowment, with scholarships for all students, and we will triple the salary of all of our employees. But that's not a reachable vision. It's not something that any amount of strategic planning is going to accomplish in 5 years. So we want to stretch ourselves with a vision statement, but we want to be able, at the end of the 5-year period, to look back and say, yes, we reached the place we said we would go. And the vision statement needs to be compelling. It needs to be the sort of thing that when somebody reads it, they say, yeah, I'd like to be a part of that. That sounds like what I signed up for. One of the best mission statements I know of comes from the Berkeley, California public school system. And let me just read this to you. It's one paragraph. It's actually part of a larger vision document. They have a paragraph describing their students, their teachers. But here's their paragraph describing the vision for their school system. Our schools are vital centers of community life, enriched by the diversity of our city and welcoming to all families. Each classroom offers engaging and culturally relevant curriculum that builds on students' interests and abilities. Student needs, as identified by regular assessment, inform our teaching and guide appropriate and effective intervention services. We offer an enriched learning environment and a comprehensive system of supports to address the needs of the whole child. That's aspirational, but it's not ridiculous. It's achievable. It's ambitious. And it's a school system where I read this and I say, yeah, that's where I want my kids. I want my kids in a place like that that isn't in Berkeley, California, because starter homes there are like $5 million. But if we could have one here, that's what I want. Okay, so we have a lot of planning work that has been done. And after we create the vision statement, then this group needs to take that vision, look at where we are right now, look at the distance between where we are and where we want to go, and create between 5 and 8 goals that are going to get us from point A to point B. These goals are going to be the backbone of the strategic plan. They will all have objectives underneath them. Those objectives will all have multiple action steps. So the goals have to be fairly broad. They have to be able to encompass different aspects of the institution, and they have to be things that we can break out into different objectives. And each goal is going to have 3, 4, 5 or more objectives underneath it that are going to be a little bit more targeted towards the individual area. So a goal should be something that all areas of the university are going to have some part of, whereas the objectives underneath the goal may apply specifically to student affairs or athletics or academic affairs. So just as we set these goals, look hard at the vision statement and ask ourselves, what gets us to where we want to be? We have, from the last strategic plan, we had 7 core goals. And this is just for your reference. You're not obliged to use any of these, but these are things that a different planning process produced at a different time, and it's definitely merits our attention. So from 2011, we set our goals as follows: to sustain and enrich a curricular and co-curricular experience of exceptional quality and impact, to expand and enrich the university's international programs and engagement to achieve national prominence, to ensure a work environment that honors and values the contributions of all community members and their continuing professional growth, to attract and retain a student body of high academic achievement and personal aspiration, to model and teach social responsibility in the local and global community, to make the world better aware of the distinctive and transformative character of a UE education, to secure the resources necessary to support the university's pursuit of excellence. So these are the sorts of goals that take us to a vision. And I look through this list and I think, yeah, we did accomplish some of these things. Our international programs certainly did expand and certainly did get national attention during this time. So I think that these goals represent a pretty good completion of a vision. But it's not the same vision that we have for the next 5 years. That's something we still have to decide as a community. The last thing I want to look at are the objectives that have been set out in the area strategic plans that most of the units and the university did last year. We had, if you're on faculty, we spent a lot of time on the academic strategic plan, and we have strategic plans from the other areas as well. And there are goals in there. These goals are probably, if we're doing our job right, these goals should come out as objectives in the current strategic plan because they're area specific, but they all speak towards a couple of major and important things that we're trying to do. So one of the tasks of this committee is to look at the objectives that people are already setting out for themselves and figure out a way to create goals that amplify those objectives. That a goal area should go across different areas of the university, but the objectives that have been set out can be part of those goals. So use the work that's already been done and create some goals that will allow these objectives to become part of the strategic plan. So I'm going to show you the various objectives. I've excerpted them from each of the strategic plans. All of these plans are loaded onto the SharePoint site. So I'm just going to go through very quickly. I'm not going to read them because you can all read yourselves. So I will just play some background music while we go.